Protect your DNA. BioPQQ can promote formation of new mitochondria. InfoWarsStore.com.
Attorney General Jeff Sessions has recused himself from any future investigations into the allegations that the Russians influenced our election somehow. Did they hack the election in collusion with the Trump campaign to oust Hillary Clinton? Jeff Sessions doesn't care. He says it's a nothing burger. He has recused himself. Now, his critics are going to say that this is an admission of guilt. He seemed to be very lighthearted about it at his press conference, saying, you know what, there's nothing to see here, so I don't even need to be in control of it. But here's the Sessions controversy explained. So this is how he found himself at the center of this political fray. Now, the critics accused the former senator of purposefully lying about contacts that he had with the Russian ambassador. These were comments made by Sessions under oath during his confirmation hearing for Attorney General on January 10th. Now, he was asked by Democratic Senator Al Franken about contacts with any Russian government-related entities during the course of the Trump campaign. Sessions said he wasn't aware of any such meetings, including any evidence that anyone affiliated with the Trump campaign communicated with the Russian government in the course of the campaign. And that's the clincher, because he was asked regarding in the course of the campaign, dealing with the Trump campaign. And he responded saying he wasn't aware of any of those activities. Now, the opponents there say that when Senator Franken was questioning him, those questions were all-encompassing. He should have just known. Any meeting whatsoever should have been disclosed by the former senator. But supporters argue that Franken's comments were in the context of campaign duties, unrelated to Sessions' role as a senator and member of the Senate Armed Services Committee. He's a member of the Senate Armed Services Committee, so of course he's going to be speaking with all sorts of ambassadors, including the Russian ambassador, and he was under no obligation to make them aware of that, because frankly, they would have just said, oh, see, talking to the Russians, there we go, right there, that's proof, that's all you need, when he was doing his job. Now, Sessions' spokeswoman said that Sessions' answer was honest, given the context of Franken's question. She said, the attorney general has been very clear that as a senator, he had conversations with the Russian ambassador. Last year, the senator had over 25 conversations with foreign ambassadors as a senior member of the Armed Services Committee, including the British, Korean, Japanese, Polish, Indian, Chinese, Canadian, Australian, German, and Russian ambassadors. A big duh, because guess what? He's not a civilian. He was a senator and a senior member of the Armed Services Committee. So, of course, he's going to be speaking with countries when they're dealing with weapons and arms. Now, President Trump has responded to all this, saying that he has total confidence in Sessions. Again, a big nothing burger, but the left is going to see this as a win because they can use this to taint the public's impression of Trump's administration. Now, the fact that they so easily tossed General Flynn aside, we knew that this was coming. We knew that they weren't just going to be satisfied with that. They're going to continue to chip away at anybody that Donald Trump brings into his administration. And going on with that, we see immediately some people there in the GOP rush to eat their own. There was many Republicans quick to pile it on as he was being targeted by the media. So this is why he recused himself. He just said, you know, we don't want to turn this into a big political thing. It's a nothing burger. I don't need to be in charge of any investigations into Russia because you're not going to find anything. So I don't need to be there to, in your eyes, oversee this thing and protect Donald Trump and people within his campaign and his administration. Much unlike the former Attorney General Loretta Lynch, who refused to recuse herself when they were investigating Hillary Clinton. Of course, she didn't recuse herself. She gave the illusion that she would step back and she would allow the FBI director, James Comey, she would, you know, go with whatever he said, but she would reserve the right to, you know, fight back if she didn't agree with the findings there with Hillary Clinton. So total difference here where he said, you know what, I don't need to protect Donald Trump. I recuse myself from this. Loretta Lynch would not recuse herself. Meanwhile, you know, why are they rolling out the dinosaur John McCain? Okay, nobody cares what he says, but this is a man who met with ISIS. Okay, so he goes to Syria and he meets with these Syrian rebels, of course, who defected to ISIS or, you know, Al-Qaeda's army and had a picture with them. He had another secret trip taken to Syria. And again, former President Barack Obama, let's not even get into who he spoke with, unbeknownst to the American people. And of course, many, many people within the administration, he sent billions of dollars to Iran, with this hostage exchange. Let's not forget that. Now, of course, initially they lied about it, said it was about only about $400 million sent in these unmarked bills to Iran in last January. But of course, later we found out it was like $1.3 billion to Iran after the hostages were released. This is Iran that still says and chants death to America. They just released another film, Battle of the Persian Gulf 2. This is an Iranian film hailing the demise of the U.S. Navy in an imagined Gulf battle. So they're already still putting out this propaganda, death to America. Actual state sponsors of terror, Syria, Iran, even Saudi Arabia. Nobody, everyone's fine with the fact that they're meeting with those actual state sponsors of terror. But if the senator in his job as a senior member of the Armed Services Committee has to speak to the Russian ambassador, that's a huge scandal. So this is the problem here. You know, Russia isn't even on the list of state sponsors of terror, mind you. So frankly, it's okay that if you're doing your job and you need to speak with them, but for whatever reason, we're allowed to send billions of dollars to Iran states. Nothing to see here, folks. That's completely okay. You know, if he wants to annihilate the Middle East and bomb them to the tune of a bomb dropped about every 20 minutes, that's completely fine. But, you know, if you speak to the Russian ambassador in the context of doing your job, well, everybody freak out, okay, if you're on the left. Now, here's what this is all about. We had talked about this before, Daily Caller saying this is confirmed. The Obama administration sabotaged Trump's transition to the White House. This is according to the New York Times. Obama White House officials waged a campaign to procure, save, and disperse classified intelligence regarding Trump associates' contacts with Russians. This campaign involved curtailing the Trump team's access to highly classified information, and then they would lower the classification ratings on other information about this ongoing Russian investigation so that it could be more widely shared across the government. Oh, and by the way, leaked to the press time and time again. So you can see how we've been talking that there's kind of this coup going on within the government, the shadow government, the people who see themselves as the real government, the unelected government. They are waging a war against Donald Trump and his administration because Obama cannot stand the fact that everything that he and his people work so hard for is going to be dismantled. Now, going back to this other article, it points out how this wide-ranging report includes information that isn't positive for Trump, including that federal investigators were given intelligence from foreign services that some Trump associates met with the Russians in the Netherlands and Britain. But they again point out, once again, that U.S. officials do not have any evidence of any coordination between Trump advisors and the Russian government to influence the election. So again and again and again, they're saying there's no evidence there of any wrongdoing, but here everyone should get really excited and freaked out about this. Now, the FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe told Trump's Chief of Staff Reince Priebus that the entire story was BS. So there you go. And this is all in alignment with Obama's goal to oust Trump from the presidency via impeachment or resignation. Why do you think President Barack Obama hasn't slithered off to Hawaii to go play perpetual golf games? He is right there, ready to jump back into politics, leading the charge to oust Donald Trump from the presidency. This is according to a close family friend who tells the Daily Mail. They report Obama is being aided in his crusade by ex-senior advisor Valerie Jarrett. She's actually moved into Obama's house, his house there in D.C., into the Nerve Center. This is just 2 miles away from the White House. This is going to serve as the big place to mount the insurgency against Trump. Now, on Tuesday, former Attorney General Eric Holder also revealed that Obama was close to returning as a full-time political operative. Holder told reporters, "It's coming, he's coming, and he's ready to roll." Oh my gosh, that sounds like a movie trailer to a very scary movie about the future that is going to befall us all. So the family source tells the newspaper that Obama's ultimate goal was to force Trump to step down either through resignation or impeachment, and that the former president is dismayed at the way Trump is tearing down his legacy, Obamacare, the social safety net, and the welcome mat for refugees that Obama put in place. Bye. So this is why the Obama administration, they're still around. And the people that are kind of working within the shadow government, working on the little coup to oust anyone that Trump brings in, because they truly feel that their unelected themselves are just waiting in the wings. This is why President Obama is there behind his walled-in D.C. mansion. But speaking of fake news, I know Darren McBreen is actually going to be working on a very important story. He'll be breaking it on the Alex Jones Show tomorrow, as well as for the InfoWars Nightly News. But Darren, tell us what you're working on. It's very key.
Well, we're working on an investigative report that has busted the mainstream media big time, not only broadcasting fake news, but they are actually creating fake news websites, passing it along as the real thing. And what happens, people, they see these stories online, and millions of people have shared these stories on Facebook thinking it's the real thing. Mm-hmm. But when we investigate further, they're absolutely made up websites. And I got a couple of the names for you right now. Salt Lake City Guardian. There's no such thing, right? But they make up a website. And then what happens is people see these headlines, and it's everything from Lady Gaga to Donald Trump and vaccinations. But what I think what they're trying to do is they're trying to saturate social media with all these bogus fake news stories. That way, when the average person on social media, they run across an InfoWars article or they see something from Breitbart or the Drudge Report, they're confused. They're not really sure if it's real or not. And like I said, it saturates everything. So they don't know what to trust. And I think that's their end game. But the big news here is we have busted the establishment media launching fake news websites. And we're going to have a full report tomorrow night. And it'll also be on the Alex Jones Show tomorrow.
Wow. Thank you, Darren. That's really going to be exciting. Looking forward to that, because of course this is just going to underscore their narrative that the fake news is what helps sway the election, and they just want to confuse the hell out of everyone so that Obama can get his wish of going back to the olden days of the three major news agencies giving everyone the information that they needed. We need to do away with this open, free, wild, wild west of the internet, which has allowed the masses, the sleeping giant, to awaken and tear down that globalist plan. Which is another reason why they are really in a flurry to make this all happen before these elections coming up in France as well as Germany, because they can see that this is a global awakening. Worldwide, this is happening, and they are seeing their globalist agenda being dismantled. Now, here is some video from earlier of a savage assault doled out by Marine Le Pen. She said it directly to Angela Merkel's face, calling Germany a servant to America. Let's go ahead and play this clip.
Vous venez tous deux ici en séance de rattrapage, car votre Union européenne est en train de s'effondrer, aggravant les assauts migratoires comme les assauts économiques, et obligée de se maintenir par le chantage, la menace et l'intimidation. Votre modèle, c'est la vassalisation aux États-Unis, l'austérité, la concurrence déloyale, la surveillance massive des citoyens, le dumping social, la submersion migratoire.
So you can see how upset Marine Le Pen is talking about, she represents an intelligent protectionism, individual liberties, and the defense of safety and identity, and really lambasting Angela Merkel for telling people that they can't speak the truth. And she herself, Marine Le Pen, has been a victim of this. The EU lawmakers have actually lifted Le Pen's EU parliamentary immunity on Thursday. So what this means, Le Pen is under investigation in France for posting three graphic images of Islamic State executions on Twitter in December 2015. Oh, big no, can't do that there. That includes the beheading of American journalist James Foley. Now, Le Pen's immunity shields her from prosecution, but by lifting it just over a month before the first round of the French presidential election, after a request from the French judiciary, the parliament is going to allow any eventual legal action against her for posting videos that were posted all over the internet. But she's not allowed to post things that expose the truth. And that's what she's saying, that she's not afraid to put the truth out there. And no one should be afraid to put the truth out there while we are being infiltrated, especially the West, especially what they're dealing with in Europe. You can't post the facts that the opponents don't like. Just like investigative journalist Tim Pool, who was there in Sweden. He was forced to leave the migrant suburb in Sweden after he was followed by masked men. So this is after the left is continuing to claim that there are these no-go areas that Donald Trump was talking about, that they don't exist. So this is Tim Pool, and he was there. He had huge problems. So let's go ahead and take a look at these clips.
We have to get a police escort right now. We've been warned by them that it could get really dangerous if we don't leave right now from Rinkeby. Yeah. So it's the middle of the day.
Yeah. Police are following.
The police are following us because we're being followed. The police have warned us that if we don't leave now, things are going to get bad. They said within minutes, 50 people could be here.
So this is reporter Tim Poole, and rather than just be told by the mainstream media that there's nothing to see here, these no-go zones don't exist, Donald Trump is wrong, he went to Sweden to conduct interviews in these migrant suburbs to get an accurate picture of what's happening. He actually traveled to Rinkeby, which was the scene of last week's riots. Cars were set ablaze, journalists, shopkeepers, police, they were all attacked there. So he goes there, he said, honestly, I thought we would be totally safe to go in there and ask people what life was like. I really didn't expect that to happen, the fact that the police told him he was going to get chased out by a bunch of people with rocks. But you know what? Salon.com says that the Swedish migrant suburbs are safe and that no-go areas don't exist. So it's fake news. It must be true.
This is one of the biggest secrets out there. The missing link of why our ancestors, whether you were in Africa or ancient Albion, which is England today, why our ancestors were so much stronger. I mean, there are huge archaeological reports, all sorts of anthropology studies, you can look them up for yourself, that show that humans, just an average farmer of 10,000 years ago in England, was stronger than Olympic athletes today. In the final equation, everyone knows our modern society has lost its vitality. The sperm counts are down like 90%. People are falling apart. They're totally depressed. They're unhappy. What is going on? Every ancient culture was obsessed with what I'm about to reveal to you. Today we call it bone broth, and for thousands of years our ancestors enjoyed its benefits before it became lost to our modern diets of processed junk. That's why I'm so excited to announce the product that is undoubtedly the jewel in the crown of InfoWars Life products. Caveman. We lost our vitality because we just ignored the ancient traditions. Everyone knew that you used all the parts of the animal. You used the skin to cover yourself or for shelter. You used the meat for sustenance, the fat for cooking, but you used the bones for strength. We are now introducing Caveman by InfoWarsLife.com, the ultimate in true paleo nutrition with bone broth, turmeric root, chaga mushroom, and seven total primal superfoods in a single great-tasting formula. The bone is so amazing. From the outside structure full of minerals and key cofactors to the marrow that produces the blood for the body, this is the engine of the life essence. I've made a lot of important points here, but this is the one you need to research for yourself because it's so key. High-quality bone broth helps support healthy muscles and connective tissue, while the active compounds in turmeric do battle on the cellular level and help fight free radicals. And collagen is essential to aid healthy tendons, ligaments, and muscle tissue. This is an absolute win-win. You get an amazing product produced right here in America. You support InfoWars and all we're doing to promote freedom and the restoration of our republic and promotion of freedom worldwide. The journey towards better health and giving our bodies these amazing compounds that God created starts at InfoWarsLife.com. 3 years in the making, incredible research, and the very best ingredients. I'm Alex Jones, and I may not be a caveman, but compared to these trendies out there in the street, I'm as close as it gets. Join me at InfoWarsLife.com and get your caveman formula today.